XFM News. On point. To XFM. My name is Barbara Nyamwiza. Presidential candidate Patrick Amuriat has been arrested by police at Nkombe, a few kilometers from Chamhunga on the Ishaka Kasese Highway as he headed to Rubirizi for his campaigns. Amuriat was intercepted at about 9 a.m. and ordered into a police vehicle before being driven to Mbarara. According to police spokesperson for Greater Bushenyi, Marshal Tumsime, Amuriat was arrested for knocking down a police officer, the district police commander from Mbarara, John Rutajira, while the latter was trying to intercept him. The presidential hopeful had allegedly defied the police and used a motorcycle to go through the road he had been stopped from using.
He was being guided by the DPC and his team which route to follow. But for him, he defied the orders, and instead, he decided to jump onto a motorcycle. In the process, when the DPC tried to have with them, tell them not to follow the route they were not supposed to follow, the DPC, one called President of Police, Rutajira John, was knocked down by that motorcycle.
Amuriat continued, he escaped narrowly, and continued up to Bushenyi to do his campaigns. So today, there was communication between Mbarara and Bushenyi, so Amuriat has been arrested and has been taken back to Mbarara to answer charges of why he knocked and he didn't follow the procedures in Mbarara.
One of his drivers, Nasu Basalirwa, was also arrested on Wednesday for allegedly obstructing a police officer on duty, but later released on Thursday. The Rizzi Regional Police spokesperson, Samson Kasasara, has said that investigations are still going on to bring other culprits to book. A reporter managed to speak to Amuriat before he was taken inside Mbarara Central Police Station to record a statement, and he had this to say.
Where he did this and how he did this. So it's something that the DPC here will explain to me. The arresting officer was the RPC who were violently arrested, beaten up before being arrested. And I think it's very unbecoming of the police force that we think is just merely being misused.
Patrick Oboy Amuriat, who is the presidential hopeful on the FDC ticket. And presidential candidate Henry Tumukunde is in the Acholi sub-region, and after that he heads to the Lango sub-region, and there he is asking people to vote him in appreciation for his father, who voted the Dr. Milton Obote in the 1962 general election. Tumukunde argues that his father supporting Dr. Obote is a debt that the people of Lango owe to him and should repay by voting for him in the 2021 election. It should be remembered that today is day two of General Tumukunde's campaign in the region, and he will be in Apac, Kwania and Amorata as per his campaign schedule.
And when you make me a president, I will make sure I come back and be your president. I'm the one who actually worked with Macho Dogo, and I went to school with Akena, same law school. Now, I have come to tell you to support change. The time change has come, Allah, Allah, now. And I have come that you pay me my debt. My father voted Obote in 1962 in Rukunjiri. So, it's time to pay me back.
General Tumukunde there. Presidential candidate William Mayambara is today expected to campaign in Maracha, Koboko and Yumbe districts after failing to campaign in Arua district yesterday. Mayambara yesterday set off with his team to campaign in the West Nile, his first district being Arua, but says that this was not possible after reaching the place when the time for campaigns had ended. Mayambara also reveals their day was further complicated when they failed to access accommodation due to lack of funds, but says this will not deter them as he is ready to proceed to the other districts.
But it's because we didn't have the money for the lodges. But as people in the struggle, that cannot be a hindrance. Mayambara, in my world, they say everything is possible, commonly aired out in Uganda as Chisoboka. So that's why I'm sleeping here.
That's Willie Mayam that talking to us there. Now, Matters Sports, a total of 9 players from Police FC and Bakisa Giants have tested positive for the coronavirus in the tests conducted ahead of their Uganda Premier League opening game today. According to reliable sources from the FUFA COVID Task Force, 7 of Bakisa Giants players have tested positive, while Police FC has 2 players and have already gone into self-isolation. However, the rest of the players have tested negative and will be available for selection. Police and Wakiso Giants game was to kick off today at 4 p.m. at Lugogo, and it will still go ahead and be live on TV. Elsewhere, Bull Football Club hosts Sports Club Villa, while Mbara City takes on Uganda Revenue Authority at Kacheka Stadium. Wakiso Giants head coach Douglas Bamweyana is happy with the team's preparations and the depth in squad.
I'm very happy with our preparations. We're happy with the squad. We're happy with everything around the club, as witnessed by even this very particular day. And so we're looking forward to unleashing what we feel is a challenge to the status quo.
Elsewhere in the world, 3 members of a leading Egyptian human rights group detained in Cairo last month have been freed following widespread international criticism. The men, who worked for the Egyptian Initiative for Personal Rights, EIPR, were accused of links with a terror group and spreading false news. The UN's Human Rights Agency had described the arrests as chilling. Celebrities Emma Thompson, Stephen Fry and Scarlett Johansson joined politicians in criticizing the arrests. EIPR is an independent group whose work covers a variety of political, civil, economic and social issues in the world. A researcher for the group, Patrick Zaki, who was arrested in February, is still in detention. EIPR says he is being held on suspicion of spreading fake news, misusing social media and inciting protests without permission. Dozens of activists have been arrested under Egypt's President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, who led the military's overthrow of his democratically elected predecessor, Mohamed Morsi, in 2013, following protests against his rule. And Matters Health, U.S. President-elect Joe Biden has said he will ask Americans to wear masks for the first 100 days in office to curtail the spread of coronavirus. He told the press he believed there would be a significant reduction in COVID-19 cases if every American wore a face covering. Mr. Biden also said he would order masks to be worn in all government buildings. The U.S. has recorded 14.1 million cases and 276,000 deaths from COVID-19, the highest of any country in the world. Mr. Biden is preparing to take office as pharmaceutical giants are poised to ship millions of doses of coronavirus vaccines to the American public. The UK on Wednesday became the first country in the world to approve the Pfizer vaccine. That's it. My name is Barbara Nyamwiza. Stay right here at XFM. XFM News. On point.